Hello everyone, so right before I start explaining this performance, let me suggest three things. One is knowing how to do the back pump production, okay? And two, this is optional, knowing how to do the switch production, okay? And the third one is how to do your own cards for card productions. I already have those three links in this video description. Just go to this video fullness, okay? Now, this is the way it is done. Because I'm back palming these cards, when I produce them, I'm gonna use the index finger and I'm gonna slide it through the packet. And I'm gonna try to push against the top two cards, okay? So these top two cards are gonna be the ones I throw away. Let me get rid of it so you can see what it's doing. The index finger over here is pushing against the pinky. So I'm squaring from the long side of the packet. To square from the short side, just bring these two fingers close to the base of the thumb, so you square on the short side. So at this point, I need to reuse these cards by stretching the fingers. And these cards, whatever quantity you have over here, they're gonna help to conceal any possible flashes, okay? But you still have to swing up and down, or front and back, whatever you wanna use. So that's gonna be better, but I don't wanna shake, so you can see better what I'm doing. You throw the cards, okay, and then produce them again. Once you already have them over here, you slide the index finger once again and push any quantity you want against the pinky finger. I'm gonna show it from the back in a minute. Just let me show it to you what I'm doing over here. And then I'm gonna throw them on the floor or in a magician's hat. Now, if you have a magician's hat, try to keep your hand close. Just drop it right there. Don't keep your hand too far away from it and don't put your hand right inside the magician's hat. Now, if you're gonna throw them on the floor, try to at least drop three cards, okay? Because it is a long distance, so the audience can see it's not just one card. Now, I'm gonna show it to you once again from the back, so you can see better, but I'm gonna use these other cards, okay? So it is easier to notice. This is from the back. I'm gonna produce the card. You have to be familiar with a back palm production. I'm gonna slide the index finger, okay? I'm gonna push away whatever quantity I'm gonna drop on the floor and re-grip with the index finger the packet against the pinky finger. Now the audience, they don't see the index finger, but they see the pinky finger. Just don't keep it stretched. You can fold it over here. And by pushing with the index finger against the pinky, you're squaring from the long side of the packet. But you still have to bring these two fingers, the index and the pinky, let me get rid of this, to the base of my thumb. So you can square over here as well. Okay, so it's not gonna be too messy when you reuse these cards. Okay, so it is an easy move to know how it is done, but it's not an easy move to accomplish it, okay? So once you already have the cards, you don't really see how many you are separating with the index. You just have the feeling because you're not really looking in the back. If anything, you're looking in the front. And this is just an estimation. It doesn't have to be exactly. Okay, I'm reusing the cards. I'm gonna drop them and reuse these cards. Once again, push with the index finger. Try to keep as many as possible. I'm just pushing away two with the index finger, pushing against the pinky, and reusing whatever packet. These cards are gonna help you to conceal any possible flashes that you do with this packet. Okay, and three productions, that's gonna be good enough, okay? You don't have to over-exaggerate. So this is how it goes. You produce, separate it with a pinky, and do this, and drop them. Reproduce, slide it with a pinky, with an index finger, push it against the pinky, you can see from the side, and shake it, and drop them, okay? And that's gonna be enough for this part of the routine. You can drop them one at a time, or you can drop them in a bunch. But I think it's gonna look better if you drop them one at a time, not all together. And that's it. I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial.